Come on, come here, come on, come on, come on, what are you doing?
Hi, I'm Grace O'Brien, and I am in third grade, and this is a song that I made up, and it's about mermaids. Pretty mermaid swimming in the ocean, I love you. Right and true. Pretty mermaid swimming in the ocean, I love you. Right and true. Thank you. Thank you.
Happy Memorial Day. I'm going to hit a home run.
Right over there, sat on the stairs, stay or leave. The cabinets are bare, and I'm unaware of just how we got into this mess. Got so aggressive. I know we meant all good intentions. So pull me closer. Why don't you pull me close? Why don't you come on? I'm losing my mind just a little. So why don't you just meet me in the middle? In the middle. And floors are wet, and taps are still running, dishes are broken. How did we get into this mess? Got so aggressive. I know we meant all good intentions. So pull me closer. Why don't you pull me close? Why don't you come on over? I can't just let you go. Oh, baby. Why don't you just meet me in the middle? I'm losing.
My name is William, and one of my talents is running fast. One time. I don't really know what music is. Fine.
Go outside and find some jokes.
Oh, if you leave your house, you must wear your mask.
I'm not gonna wear a mask. This is not necessary. You're really overreacting.
No, I am not overreacting. You really, really want jokes? I have the same cards that you used to tell jokes in kindergarten. You can have them back.
Wait, what? Where did you get that from?
I picked them from your elementary school trash can.
That's very creepy. Let me just take this and go. Bye! Anyway, joke time. Somehow that guy managed to uncover these thingies, so it's cringe time. What do you call a guy with no arms and no legs who's on the wall? Art. What is a fish's least favorite day? Friday! Okay, how do you make a tissue dance? You put a little boogie in it. I'm doing that a lot because of my allergies. Okay, these jokes are just really bad. I'm just gonna, these are never seeing the light of day again. Anyway, guys, hope you enjoyed the video.
dream we do come true. Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up with a corner far behind me. When trouble melts like lemon drops, a high up in the chimney tops, that's where you'll find me. Wherever the rainbow, bluebirds fly. Birds fly over the rainbow. Why? No, then why can't I? If happy little birds fly beyond the rainbow, why, oh, why can't I?
I close my eyes and I can see the world that's waiting up for me, that I call my own. Through the dark, through the door, through where no one's been before, but it feels like home. They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say I've lost my mind. I don't care, so call me crazy. We can live in a world that we design. 'Cause every night I'm the brightest colors fill my head. A million dreams are keeping me awake. I think of what the world could be. A vision of the one I see. A million dreams, it's all it's gonna take. Oh, a million dreams for the world we're gonna make.
Naturally, he from the spirit and the rain, laid in the air. chop, the bass play, the brass guitar play, the tom. The flute is the tooth of soul. The wind, he can play the licks of the wind. The tom, the duck, the black fish, the fish, the belt, and the swat. They know where it's at, they know that blow.
Live from Studio HOME in the heart of Wilton, Connecticut, it's the Mid-Afternoon Show, starring Eric Fleming!
Hi, Fatima families. Today we're going to play a game called Water Wars with Great Me and Great Mr. T.
Welcome to the show, Mr. T.
How's your quarantine going, Mr. T?
It's going well. It's going well. You know, teaching and trying to stay safe and socially distant from people. So it's going well. How's yours going?
It used to be going good.
There you go.
Mr. T, you want to play a little game?
Sure. Let's play.
My little friend here will explain it. Higgins,
we're going to be playing Water War. So, we will each draw a card, and the player with the least amount of symbols on the card will lose and get a cup of water dumped on them.
Yep.
Now, when someone has all three cups of water dumped on them, they lose and get a big bucket dumped on them.
Are you ready, Mr. T? Because
sure.
Right now, we're going to do 1, 2, 3, and flip. One, two, three, flip. I got a 4.
I got a 9.
No! Okay. Please not my head.
No. I mean, literally, not lie down. Come on. Don't be squeamish.
It's just water.
It's so cold!
I'm the shot! Next card!
1, 2, 3, 4!
Jack!
Jack, uh-oh.
Oh, if put down 3 cards, but do not turn them over. Now flip the 4th one over.
First one over is a 7.
Oh, he got a 10. That means Mr. T.
You got to splash 2 of them on you.
Yep. Splash 2 cups on your head.
2 cups.
Yeah.
I have almost
one left.
Now, 1, 2, 3, 4.
I got a 6.
Queen.
Mine. Now, we are going to splash right down on his pants. Whoever loses this match will
lose
be
the
eliminated. So,
are you ready, Mr. T?
I'm ready.
Around for you.
I'm shuffling.
Now, can we get a countdown? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, war!
7-6.
Every day I'm chuckling.
That's the big bucket.
A little bit more.
And the little bit more. No. And a little bit more. And now the final shaboom, Dad is back.
No.
Mr. What? T, would you like to see a bucket?
3, 2, 1, dump it.
Yeah! I feel bad, very bad, very, very, very bad. I'm sorry there's water coming out of my mouth. Did you have fun playing?
I did. Thank you. It was fun.
Well, this has been another episode of The Mid-Afternoon Show with Eric Fleming.
Thank you.
Thank you.
My name is Olivia, and my talent is dancing.
When I look in the light, I want to see myself shine on the dance floor. But I won't get it right until I stop asking why and just let it go. Sometimes I take a look at my life, take a look at my life and say, oh.
Together but apart. It's tough and it's a sacrifice, but it's an important sacrifice that we are all making for the greater good. By enduring this great pause that we are in the midst of, we are saving lives. We are saving each other's lives. And if we offer this sacrifice to God, He will glorify it and make it holy. Ours is not the first generation that has been called up for sacrifice for the greater good. There are some who have come before us who have sacrificed much more. So, in the spirit of Memorial Day, I offer you the words of Abraham Lincoln, our beloved 16th president. 47 years ago, our fathers brought forth on this continent a new nation, conceived in liberty and dedicated to the proposition that all men are created equal. Now we are engaged in a great civil war, testing whether that nation, or any nation so conceived and so dedicated, can no longer endure. We are met on a great battlefield of that war. We have come to dedicate a portion of that field as a final resting place for those who here gave their lives and that nation might live. It is altogether fitting and proper that we should do this. But in a larger sense, we cannot dedicate, we cannot consecrate, we cannot hallow this ground. The brave men living and dead who struggled here have consecrated it, far above our poor power to add or detract. The world will little know, nor long remember what we say here, but it can never forget what they did here. It is for us, the living rather, to be dedicated to the unfinished work which they who fought here have thus far so nobly advanced. It is rather for us to be here dedicated to the great task remaining before us, that from these honored dead we take increased devotion to that cause for which they gave the last full measure of devotion, that we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain, that this nation under God shall have a new birth of freedom, and that government of the people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from the earth.